माननीय सभासदों, माननीय अध्यक्ष जी,
प्रश्नकाल क्वेश्चन नंबर 61, श्री अजय कुमार मंडल। श्री अजय कुमार मंडल, क्वेश्चन नंबर, माननीय मंत्री जी सदन पर बोलिए। क्वेश्चन नंबर 62, श्री यदवीर वाडियार।
To the questions that we asked on regarding PM Abhim, my supplementary question is as follows. Given Karnataka's diverse geographical landscape with both urban and rural disparities, it's crucial to evaluate how PM Abhim focuses on reducing regional health inequalities. Can the government provide detailed reports on how the specific healthcare centers are addressing the challenges faced by remote and rural communities in Karnataka?
Reforms and also strengthening the health services delivery and strengthening the health systems and institutions. It provides a quality service for the primary health care, for the secondary health care and for the tertiary health care. Accordingly, it is PM Abhim program is to respond to the pandemics and create a situation able to prepare ourselves effectively to respond the pandemics and disasters. Sir, here I would like to say that there are 5 activities in PM Abhim active program. Number one is strengthening the Aam Aarogya Yojana, Aam Aarogya Mandir. For that, it is decided that after the survey, units will be strengthened, which we also call as CHC. So the fourth area where we are trying to work is that we will be establishing 730 integrated public health labs, and more or less in each district we will be having an integrated public health labs. And the last area which we are trying to strengthen is that we will be creating 602 critical care blocks for the population more than 5 lakhs in the district. Sir, in the PM Abhim program, there is a framework which is being implemented through National Health Mission. Here I would also like to state that the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare only gives the technical and the financial support. The rest is to be implemented by the state government. And these facilities have to be implemented by the state government. Sir, here I would also like to share with you that nearly the total amount sanctioned is, the total amount sanctioned in PM Abhim program is 64,180 crores. And here, at this point of time, the administrative approvals have been given for the year 2021-22 to 2024-25 is 20,451.31 crores. Sir, here I would also like to share with you that 2,000, here my friends should know from Karnataka, what you are doing, it is for you, that Karnataka has got an amount of 2,021.88 crores for the state of Karnataka, where we have decided that 736 urban Aishman Arogya Mandir will be established. We have also decided that 30 integrated public health labs and 30 critical care blocks will be constructed in the state of Karnataka. So sir, nearly 30 districts will be strengthened for the betterment of the health services, technically also, and to respond to the disasters and pandemics. Sir, administrative approvals have been given, and I would like to share that 1,168 crores for strengthening of the 817 Ayushman Arogya Mandir and 21 integrated public health labs and 21 care blocks as per proposal of the state has been approved by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. So sir, there has been a survey done by the government, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, along with us, the state government, and accordingly, a target has been set, which we are implementing under the dynamic leadership of Prime Minister Modi, PM Abhim program, and I assure you that this will be completed in the time limit.
Mananiya Sadasyagan, देश की जनता चाहती है सदन चले और कई माननीय विद्वानों ने भी लिखा है कि संसद चलना चाहिए, चर्चा संवाद होना चाहिए, सहमति असहमति हमारे लोकतंत्र की ताकत है। मैं आपसे आग्रह करता हूं, जनता की भावनाओं और उनकी आशाओं आकांक्षाओं के अनुसार आप सदन चलने में सहयोग करें।